Okay then, enough dithering about. Today I'm going to start work on developing a simple game in Java. Now, at the moment I'm listening to music, which you can't hear. Take a random guess why you can't hear it. Because it's from the radio and I don't want to record that. I've heard bad stories about what happened to people who did. Anyway, I'm going to use Eclipse. I know it's outdated a bit, but it'll still work. Now, there's a couple of reasons why I'm doing this. As you can see, I was working on some other stuff. Don't mind that. That didn't really work out all that well, though. You can't see me, but this one worked out pretty well. Anyway. Oh, silly me. There we go. Now, I'm going to call this one... Actually, I'm going to think about the name for a bit, because if I give it the wrong name, it's not going to be fun to change it. I think I'll call it Engine Modular. There we go. Now, first class course is going to be called... I'll make a package. I want to make an interesting one. So... Okay, you know what? I'll just make it com. Dot, is that a secret? Oh, no. Sorry. It's been a while since I made packages. I usually just make things flat. As you can see. But I guess in this case, make it com.zenseeker.modularGame. And I'll make a class called main right in the root. Oh, no. I want... You know, whatever. I'll just put that in the jar file. And I'll be public class main... I gotta move my mic a bit. There we go. Sorry about my keyboard noise. I might fix that in post-processing, but for now it'll have to do. I'll say... Change the name of that a bit, so it's easier for me. And then string refresh, refresh args2. I'll put that try. Then catch. I know you're not supposed to name it that, but. I like that. Actually, don't bother printing the stack trace. System. Thank you. I'll just ignore all other exceptions because... Also, I won't name it that. I'll just name it E because it's not going to be used then. Cool. So, at this point, I'm going to have to look up some stuff. So, I'll be back in just a moment. Okay, I'm back. And so I'm going to make up a class called Program. I haven't really done much with these two, but basically what it's going to do is check to make sure that the class that's being requested is, extends Program, just so that we don't have any other weird errors. And I'm going to have an abstract. Should it? Public? Yes, it should. Abstract void initiate. Oh, okay. Then public abstract void close. I don't know if we'll need that. There. Public as well. And yeah, that should be good. Now, I'm actually going to want to have it extend game. And then I'll have game be another abstract class. And this one will extend program. Public abstract void. Check collision status. Actually, that won't need to be public. I'll just have that be package local. Then program I'll make it's already called initiate. Then I'll override that with an so we're going to need a string resolution int refresh. But I did. Why does that work? Okay, I'll do whatever. So then I'll just have this say system.out.println please provide resolution and refresh rate. I'll make this final as well. Cool. So that's all good. Now I think I'll put an override on this. Unless it gives me errors. Nope. Okay. There we go then. That makes more sense. So, in check status, close, initiate. Check collision status. I'm going to change that a bit. Then, abstract void draw screen. And then, what else? This will not be public, but I'm going to have this be a final void. Int identifier. And that's going to be an object. Yeah, I know I'm copying Windows a bit here, but hopefully this will work better than the Windows registry, you know? Yeah. What size should it be? No, I'm gonna have it be on a red list. Import ray list, of course. That should be good, yeah. So, dot get. Perfect.
I think I just...
Sorry. I just
crushed my
headphone wires. That's not great. Okay. Have force close. What should it do exactly? It should do a system dot exit one. And it should do a error print line closing by force caller asked for it. And actually, I'll have close be public and final. Just to help things out a bit. Stream caller. Just gonna do system.out.println closing because. And I'll put in nicely. Cool. Then I'll have a public abstract void. It doesn't need to be public. Abstract void clean up before close. Oh no, silly me. There we go. So clean up before close. Then system dot exit 0. Perfect. That's quite nice. Okay, I think that's good. So now I'm gonna test this. Have a class sample game extends game. Now it's gonna need to implement a bunch of. Oh wow, that's a lot. I'll just leave it like that for now. Is that right? We're also going to need, though, actually, I'll be an int. Also have it be dot size, then it will be object x, registry dot add x, perfect. Okay, so there we go. So yeah, I think I'll just put this in like that. I think it's called a class cat. Okay. Say something like that, and then change these out to errors because they are errors. And if all that succeeds, then we'll probably just want to do a game dot class dot get instance or dot new in there. Yeah. Okay. Oh no 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 no. How would you even instantiate this? It's abstract. Yeah, that would definitely give an error. It's already a class, so we don't need the dot class. Okay, then we're going to try. Ooh, okay. Handed no class to be run. No idea what to do. There we go. X dot initiate screen resolution int refresh. Parse. Okay, why doesn't it like that? So silly, aren't I? Catch input mismatch. Actually, no, no, no. I don't know what type of exception that one is, so I'm just gonna do exception E. E system.error not print line. Refresh rate must be a number. Perfect. That's enough error checking for the day, I think. Yeah. Yes, okay, that's good. So at least that bit works. I'll just put a full stop at the end, though, because that's helpful. And I'll make it a proper sentence, too. Good. Oh, wow, it's early in the morning. Yeah, anyway. Perfect. That's good. All this seems to be well and fine. I hope it is. So now we actually need to implement some of this stuff. Oh wait, no. Nope, we're not ready yet. We're gonna need a graphics 2D. I think these things should be in program. Definitely should be. That seems about right, yeah. And I'll have all the final methods that are actually defined there on the abstract stuff there. And for this sake, I'll just have the abstract stuff down there. Okay then. So I'll need to put a graphics 2D in here. So, but before I do that, I need to go grab some of my old code down from the GitHub. So how about let's go grab some of that? I'll be back in just a moment, I think. Or maybe even. Oh, what the? Well, that worked. That's kind of odd. Okay. So you can't see me now, because I have to go boot up Google Chrome and sign out of it and all that. And then I'll go ahead and grab my GitHub code. It'll be just a moment, I hope. Theoretically, at least. Yep. Okay. So then, ready? Here we go. Never mind. Here we go. So, since I've included my name in here, I'm just gonna casually remove that. But here's what I'm interested in. I'm interested in this class right here. So I'm going to want to grab a certain part of this that will help me to figure out. Okay. Wait, no, that's not right. You know what? I'm just gonna go to. Yeah, it'll be a moment. Okay then. Apologies for the incredibly long delay, but I've finally gotten back around to doing what I was and figured out what the problem was. So basically, I needed to convert program and game into interfaces in order for them to work better, because you can't extend two different classes in Java. And still giving a couple errors here, but those will be easy to fix. Yeah. Because I haven't implemented DrawPixel yet, but that'll be fine. So I'm going to be using Graphics 2D for this, because I'm used to working with it and it's not terribly bad to use. I'm just gonna write a couple useful methods. Perfect. So I do, however, still need to implement the draw pixel properly. That should be fairly easy. I'll just use graphics.drawLine. done. Now, obviously, it's not going to do much yet because I just told it to I think that's about right. Okay, perfect. So you got strategy, and you got strategy that. Oh, no, we can't do that yet. Sorry. Whenever define strategy, that's when we put that. Perfect. So then, in main, just try a simple graphics dot. Never mind. Zero, zero. With height, yep. Move that extra. Color dot black. Why didn't that work? Don't know yet. Oh. I do know why that didn't work. Sticking with. Did that do anything? Okay, now I'm confused. This worked. Oh, it needs to be fill rect. That makes sense then. Yeah, that makes a lot of sense then. Why I couldn't see it. There. Works. Perfect. Yes, it works. Okay then. So now, since it works, I can do quite a few things that I couldn't do before. And sorry about turning the screen off. I was testing something. Okay, the screen's back on. Anyway. So now that it works, I have to write a couple bits of code for grabbing images, etc. That's good then. So, for tonight, I'll be taking a break. Okay then. Once more, I'm returning to working on this. And this time I have a slightly different approach. So as you can see, while I was gone, I've done quite a bit of work. And now if I launch the game, it'll make a nice blue window. So now the next thing I'm going to do, as you can see I've already kind of started, is by making abstract class called Room. And so that will help with things quite a bit. So now I'm going to make I want to make an enum, but I don't think that would be good. I'll just make a class, and it'll be a final class, and I will call it Levels. Sorry about that. Someone sent something to me. So it will have a string array, Levels. Level underscore list equals new string. Three? What am I? Oh. There we go. Okay. But I'm not actually going to do that. I'm going to just do that. Cool. So now I'll have sample game. Update graphics. And then 4 int I equals 0. Actually, no. Do I want to do that? I don't know. Whatever. Silly me. I'll have to make it static, I know. Okay, so that solves that. And what should I have it do? I think I should do levels. No. Class.forName. com.eventseeker.modularGameEngine.sampleGame.levels.levels.list bracket i. This will get complicated pretty fast, won't it? Isn't it dot one? Yeah, okay. Sizes for an array list. Sorry, I got a bit confused, that's all. So, what's the issue there? I'll just put it in a try. Contact game developer, please. Cool. So that seems right. I'll have it be class room x equals class room class dot for name, blah blah. And x dot new instance. I'll just make this okay. X inst dot initialize. Isn't it supposed to be okay? I'll fix that. Should be initiate. Initiate, yep, so it's gonna be width, height, refresh. And then I'll just have it do run the script and check collision. Cool. I think that's good. Well, I don't really think we'll need this draw object and draw pixel. I just put those there in case it would be helpful. But in reality, I think it's going to be more trouble than it is helpful. Anyway. So under levels, I'll have the first level be called start. Start. It'll be public, and I will want it to superclass of com.zenith.saker.modular.game.engine.sample.game.room. Whew. That's pretty intense. I could have just typed extends room. So, well, at least the good news is it doesn't throw any errors. Yay. So, at least all this crazy reflection I'm doing is actually getting us somewhere. So, it doesn't like that because I haven't declared a serial version UID, but that's fine. I'll just add a default one. And what's the other thing? It's unchecked cast. Whatever. Because in reality, it's going to do that, and it might fail, but that's fine. Cool. So, now I know it's loading rooms at least. That's nice. So, initiate. For that, I'm going to have there be a public final int. Width. It's gonna give me a hard time with it being final, isn't it? Yeah. I'll just have it be a public int width and a public int height and a public. Do we need refresh? Yep. But I think refresh is actually going to be handled by sample game itself, so I think we can just discard refresh. Yeah. Okay. So I'll just do a little control I. Make sure everything's neat. I think it already is. Okay. So check collision. For that, we're going to want. Okay, sorry about being silent. I was just thinking. Collision map. Actually. No. Objects in collision map definitely, absolutely need to be array lists. So. Or hash maps, actually. I think that'd be better. Hash map integer collision map. So I'm not really that familiar with hash maps, but I definitely know that's what I need here. So okay, we're gonna need to import hash map. And hopefully I did that right. Huh. Oh no, not a hash map. I'm so silly. I'm sorry. It's because I used hash maps in this project right here, assembly reader. Somewhere. Parser. Yeah, I used them there because I needed a string key. But that's not actually what we want here, is it? At all. Yeah, so I think what we want, well, what I want at least, is an array that has to be accessed using two integers, but then which returns an array list. So while I think about that, I'm unfortunately gonna have to pause the video. I'll be right back in just a moment for you, but it'll probably take me 10 minutes to figure this. Sorry about being
Okay
slow,
then.
you know. So I'm just gonna check something quickly. Okay, good. Sorry about that. I believe now that I've figured out how I'm gonna implement all this ArrayList business, because I was being a bit silly trying to use three different elements. Sorry about using so many comments and all, but basically, you will grab an element from collision map, which will return an integer array, where the array element 0 is the x coordinate, 1 is the y coordinate, and 2 will be directionality. Now, because of the way I'm going to draw on the screen, I think if the y coordinate is -1 or the x coordinate is -1, then I'll set it to assume that the collision should follow a straight line, if you know what I mean. Now, diagonal collision, I haven't thought about that one yet, but I think I'll stick with square collision for now, because that won't be fun at all. But regardless, I'll just actually. Now that I got thinking about that, I think I'll make another array list called collision range. Should I? Or no, I won't. I'll have this be 4. There we go. That seems perfect. So that way we can have x range and y range in there, and that might make diagonal lines a bit easier. Now I'm not gonna film all my coding because I've noticed that I tend to do sloppier coding when I'm filming. So instead, I'll just do some work on this, but I'll return shortly after that.